ladies and gentlemen, we are approaching our station at the entrance to Main Street, USA, gateway to the seven theme lands of the Magic Kingdom. Please collect your belongings, watch your head and step, and take small children by the hand. We hope you enjoy your day at the Magic Kingdom.
Broadcasting live from 38 Studios in Providence, this is the Go Ask Mickey podcast, helping you with the tips, tricks, and the tools needed to save you time and money on your next Disney vacation. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, send them to goaskmickey@gmail.com.
Hey, what's up, everybody? And welcome to episode number 44 for the week of April 9, 2018. My name is Jerry from GoAskMickey.com. And this week, we're talking a lot of stuff. There's a lot of stuff happening this week, a lot of news. There's a lot of follow-ups. We got some info I want to share with you guys. I don't know if you've been watching a lot of the Facebook and the Twitter stuff. If you've noticed that Disney has come out with some new movie trailers for Infinity War, and I think the Solo just came out this morning or last night. So I saw both of those trailers, and they look awesome. I gotta tell you, I'm a big Star Wars fan, and I think Solo looks, I mean, from the look of it, it looks really cool. I don't know about this guy. I'm still skeptical on, you know, Han Solo is just Harrison Ford. That's the guy you always remember. So it's tough to have him in somebody else fill his shoes. So I'm going to watch that one real closely. The Infinity Wars, that looks awesome. They do a great job with the Marvel movies and all that stuff. There's so many different series that are out there. Marvel is huge now. There's tons of Netflix movies, TV shows, series, like the Luke Cage, the Iron Fist, Jessica Jones, Daredevils, the Defenders. Marvel puts together all these things and they link all these shows together. So if you're watching one, that leads into another one, which leads into this one, and this person's in that one. And it's really cool how they combine all these characters together. So it's not just the regular movie or series that you're watching. You're watching a bunch of them together. So it's kind of nice to watch that. Which brings me to the topic I want to talk to you about this week is a subscription-based service that has recently come out about movies. Now, seeing that we're talking about movies, there's a service called MoviePass. I don't know if you've heard of it. It is basically like a Netflix service that instead of you sitting at home and watching a movie, you can go to a movie theater. It's the same aspect as that Netflix version. So for MoviePass, it's $9.95 a month, so $10 a month, and you can go to the movies in a theater, anytime, any day, for an entire month. That $10 lasts you the entire month, and you can go to unlimited number of movies for that $10 a month. And all you do have to sign up for this app. It's a MoviePass app. You go to MoviePass.com, you sign up for the app, they send you a card. Now, this card comes in the mail like 2 weeks later, and it's set up on your phone. So when you set up this card, you get the card, you set up the app on your phone, and all you have to do is when you're within like a couple of miles of the movie theater, you can click onto that movie theater, you can buy your tickets, go in, either pick up your tickets or go to a kiosk with your card, and you're into the movie. Now, this will pay for itself after, I think, about two visits to a movie theater. You know, an average movie, depending on where you are, depending on what theater it is, you could spend an average of $10 for one ticket to any type of a movie. Now, with this, as long as you're seeing two movies a month, I think you're covered too as far as payment. It pays for itself after about two visits. Now, there are certain tips and ideas that you want to get from this service that will help you make the best out of this service. Now, with MoviePass, they required you to physically be at the theater in order for you to purchase a ticket. Now, it checks your location through your GPS on your app. So it kind of follows you, which is a little creepy. But if you're going to the movie theater and you're going to watch a movie, for $10 a month, that's not a bad deal. So showing up a prime time showing of like a huge, like say you want to go see Infinity Wars. If you show up and there's 10,000 other people, you're probably not going to get a ticket. It doesn't guarantee you a seat. It follows you to show and pay, but it doesn't guarantee you a seat. So that's the only downfall I'm finding of this service. Also with the service, you cannot buy like concession, the snacks, popcorn, all that stuff. You have to pay out of pocket for that. But you still make out on the long run. If you go to the movies a lot, and if you're a frequent, you know, person that frequents the movies, go to a theater, whatever, most kids go all the time every week. So for somebody like a teenage kid or somebody in their 20s or whatever, they are going to get the most out of this. You know, sometimes you go to a movie and it stinks or whatever. If the movie sucks, you just get up and leave. You didn't pay for it. You know what I mean? You pay $10 a month to sit and watch different movies. If the movie sucks, you can just get up and leave. You're not committed. Well, I paid $10. I gotta get my money's worth. You know, so this shows you the versatility of this service. You know, if you're walking in and you're not sure what movie you want to watch, this gives you an option. Hey, I can watch whatever thing because it's not coming out of my pocket. Now, this service can also be used with the rewards service of your local theater. Say over here, we have a Showcase Cinema, and I believe that's AMC, and they have a rewards program that they do, Star Pass, I think it's called. And you could see, you could save up so many points every time you go in and you watch a movie and you get like a free popcorn or you get a free ticket or you get some kind of thing, free candy, free soda, whatever it is. And you get those rewards for using this frequently. With service like this, you can get more of those things because you're frequenting these theaters and these movies more often. So you're going to get more money back into your pocket, saving you that $27.95 for a popcorn that is loaded with salt. I got to say that. I've tried many times, I don't know about you, but I have tried so many times to get that popcorn, movie theater popcorn at home. It doesn't work. You have to actually go to a movie theater to get that type of a popcorn. I've tried all different kinds of microwave popcorns. I've tried popping it on my own. Nothing works. You cannot get that microwave, like, it's not the same thing. You have to go to a movie theater to get that. Disney popcorn is number two. Movie theater popcorn, to me, is number one. That's how it works. But with the service like this, you can save on the other end as far as snacks and popcorn and all that stuff goes. So there are different ways you can use this thing. You know, if you do find that you want to go see Infinity Wars or whatever, you can physically go in the morning and buy a ticket for that evening. So that will save you that time of waiting. Now you already have a ticket. So say the movie comes out on a Friday, whatever the date is, I think it's the 27th. If you go out and you buy that ticket that morning when that movie theater opens, use your movie pass, that's a free ticket for that show. And you get to see it at night. You don't have to go. You could just go whenever that time is for that movie that you wanted to see. And you don't have to wait in line. You don't have to fight people to get into the theater. You're guaranteed a seat. So that's a different way around how this movie pass is working. There are different ways to use this. But other than that, I think it's a great option for people that go to see movies all the time, that constantly are, you know, going out for dinner and a movie, that you can't lose with this. If you go twice a month, you're guaranteed to make your money back. So I would definitely check this thing out. It's called moviepass.com. Check them out over there. And sign up if you can. They are really expanding. They're getting a lot bigger, especially coming with all these Disney movies that are coming out. The Solo, the Infinity Wars, the Christopher Robin, I think, is coming out. The Mary Poppins is coming out. You get right there. There's four movies. That's $40. You just saved a ton of money. You go see them all in 1 month. That's awesome. So check them out. Also, check us out. You can stalk us on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram over at Gorse Mickey Podcast, and check us out, follow us, like us, make fun of us over there. And where else? If you have any questions, comments, suggestions, anything, send them on over to goaskmickey@gmail.com. Now, I want to talk to you about a follow-up that I've been trying to figure out from a couple of weeks ago. We did an episode about Uber Eats. Now, Uber Eats is like an Uber service, except they are delivery of food. And especially when you're down at Disney, you want, you know, something decent rather than food court meals. Say you're at the All Stars or Pop Century or wherever, you want a better selection. You can bang up Uber Eats on your phone and you get an app and you can order food and they bring it to you. So that's a service that is available through this Uber Eats app. And it's really great idea, especially when you're on vacation down in Florida. You're busy. You're doing something. You are going back to a hotel. You want to order some food, but you don't want that cheeseburger, that piece of cardboard pizza from the food court. You want something decent. There are a ton of restaurants available in that area, the I-4 area of Disney, that can bring you food. Now, there's a problem with that because Disney has sold the Crossroads Shopping Center to the Florida Department of Transportation. Disney owns that property. They own the Crossroads Shopping Center. And they recently just sold it to the Florida Department of Transportation. Now, this is an article that I read from Walt Disney World News Today. They first told us about this Crossroads Shopping Center back in 2016. And we have a firm date on the closing of the favorite shopping center, the closest to Walt Disney World property. According to Orlando Business Journal, the Florida Department of Transportation has offered Disney $146 million to buy the 150,000 square foot retail complex. Now, they offered Disney that money. The appraisal values the land at $45 million and the buildings at $101 million. The 37-acre property is located at the intersection of I-4 and SR-535. And it's directly across from Hotel Plaza Boulevard, which connects right to Disney Springs. Now, the land is required as part of the I-4 Beyond the Ultimate project and will be used for a new exit ramp, an intersection improvement, and a retention pond. So they want to take this property and demolish it so they can put an exit ramp and to improve the intersection. So basically, they have a drawing up that all of the property will be affected. The Radisson, the Waffle House are not part of the Crossroads plot, but are wedged into the triangle plot located around 535, and it seems to be spared at this time, but surely will be negatively impacted by the construction. So a few of these shops are going to be affected. Some will not close. The shopping center is probably most well known for the Gooding Supermarket, which is a premier supermarket for Walt Disney World patrons to visit due to proximity to the Disney property. So a lot of people go to this supermarket right before they hit the resorts and they buy their food for the week or wherever. Now that's going to be gone. There is going to be nowhere. You're going to have to go other places, Walmart or wherever, to buy your supermarket stuff. So apparently, these tenants will receive notice of the pending sale and have been told they have 18 months to vacate the property and it will likely be closed outright. My problem with this was that you used Uber Eats for those local restaurants because they were available there. They had a McDonald's, they had Taco Bell, they had Burger King, they had all these restaurants around in that plaza that were available for a quick snack, food, whatever. You had that supermarket that was there. This was a convenience for any tourist that went to Disney World that had access to a car. Now, with Uber Eats, you don't have access to a car because now you're getting charged for parking. Guess what? Disney takes that away too. Now, Disney sold it outright to the Department of Transportation. So Disney is in charge of this transaction. So they took away all these areas and all these food options away, leading you to do what? You have to eat somewhere, right? Now you can't get food at a supermarket. You don't have transportation to supermarkets. You know, you can't use the Uber Eats because now those were participating restaurants that were in the Uber Eats app. So when you went to the Uber Eats app, they give you a list of participating restaurants that were in this, and you could pick from those certain restaurants. Now you can't. They're gone. So that makes your increased price, your time and money. Now Disney makes out on this deal because Disney takes away that food option. You got to eat somewhere, right? You can either go to Disney Springs, you can go to Disney World, the resorts, wherever you're going to eat. They're going to force you to eat somewhere as long as it's not there. So, you know, a lot of people say there's a big controversy on this subject because they're saying, well, they have to take this land. No, they're selling the land. It's a transaction. You own the land. It's not required. It's not a, we're taking the land. If that was the case, they would just come in and take it. That doesn't happen that way. So with this type of a transaction like this, it makes you wonder, what is Disney doing? Why are they taking this? Use this as a, you know, a guide to what you want to do as far as, so when you do plan a vacation and you're going down thinking, well, I can go here, I can go there. No, plan, try to plan ahead and make your judgment from there. Disney knows what they're doing, and they're doing it no matter what. So keep that in mind next time you're going down to Disney. Check out those places because they're not going to be that long. All right, we're moving on. If you could, check out our affiliate link over at our webpage at goasmickey.com. Click on our Amazon link and buy whatever you want through our Amazon link. That helps us to support the show, you know, and if you could do that, that would be great. We would appreciate that. We're going to come back with some news, huge, a lot of news this week. We're going to come back and we're going to talk to you and we're going to hit you with all that stuff coming up in 2 minutes and 2 seconds. Be right back.
You're listening to the Go Ask Mickey podcast.
Oh my God!
Good evening. I'm Ron Burgundy, and this is what's happening in your world tonight.
Hey, welcome back. There's a lot of things going on this week. So much. All right, we're going to get into it right away. All right, we're going to hit it with the Sweet Beverly Suite. Sweet Spells is leaving. This sucks. Sweet Spells closes next week at Hollywood Studios. Now, I don't know if you know of this place. This has been rumored for a little bit. That last month, it looks like it has been confirmed that the Sweet Spells snack location at Hollywood Studios will be closing its doors forever on April 15th. So next week, the space is occupied by this bakery, and the treat shop will be converted into additional retail space. So they're moving this out, the Sweet Treats, and they're replacing it with a retail store, basically. Reported themed to a Toy Story in anticipation of the Toy Story Land opening later this year. Many of the baked goods sold at this location are already available at the Trolley Car Cafe location, hopefully including the hugely iconic carrot cake cookie. Wow. So that's awesome that they're transferring a lot of these, the popular ones, over to a different location on the trolley car. But it stinks that they gotta lose this space. They're losing it to Toy Story. So Buzz and Woody are moving in. Next we have, this is a weird one. I still don't understand this whole idea of this. A new character experience is coming to Pandora, the world of Avatar. Now beginning April 22nd, guests visiting Pandora, the world of Avatar, will be able to interact with a new utility suit pilot character. I saw a video of this. This is a little freaky. Inspired by the film, this new character can be found wandering the land wearing a Pandora Conservation Initiative utility suit to help him study the wildlife, collect plant samples, and survey Pandora's terrain. It's weird. It's just a weird robot-looking cyborg, whatever. It looks like that Transformer-ish. But it's not even good. It doesn't even look good. So, I don't know how popular this is going to be. I'd rather see characters more than this thing. But that's the way it goes. Moving on, we are doing the Grand Floridian Gala has been canceled. Several weeks ago, the Grand Floridian Resort and Spa announced that it was hosting a special $185 a night, a plate, sorry, gala to celebrate the resort's 30th anniversary on June 30th. Well, keep in mind on this date. That would include special entertainment and an open bar. However, it looks like this event has been canceled and guests who have purchased these tickets have already been refunded. June 30th, which happens to be the opening of Toy Story Land. So they probably just knocked it off because of that date. All right, we also have this week is the new FastPass Plus structure for Disney Hollywood Studios, the Toy Story Land priorities. Now, we are still about 3 months away from the opening of Toy Story Land. Club-level guests who purchased the FastPass Plus advanced reservation add-on are now able to select attractions from this new land. As you might have guessed, Hollywood Studios has changed their tier system in place at this park to deal with the opening of the new land. Now let's check this out. This is cool. Under the updated system, all three Toy Story attractions, including Toy Story Mania, are being made Tier 1. Okay? So all three. With the former top tier attractions like Fantasmic, Tower of Terror, and Rock and Roller Coaster are knocked down to Tier 2. So everything in Toy Story Land is Tier 1. You can only pick from one. And the others, you can pick two. So, Tower of Terror and Rock and Roller Coaster, those fast pass lines are going to get longer and it's going to be hard for you to get Toy Story Mania. Any Toy Story, the new Toy Story rides are going to be real difficult to get. But anyways, that's the way it goes. So we're moving on. Happily Ever After dessert parties are getting a price hike this summer. Now, first we get parking rates, and now we're getting increases on the nighttime dessert parties. One of the most popular upcharges at the Magic Kingdom is the fireworks dessert party, which offers unlimited dessert buffet as well as spectacular viewing either from the Tomorrowland Terrace, which has seating, or a standing room only on the Plaza Garden area of the hub. So it's the garden grass area, which is supposedly the cheaper one, and the Tomorrowland Terrace one is the more expensive one because you're paying for a seat. This event has always been a popular add-on, and perhaps in an effort to capitalize on this fact, Disney will be raising prices on both versions of this dessert party. Affected at the end of this month, guests who want to enjoy Tomorrowland Terrace version will see an increase from $79 to $84, and kids will go from $47 to $50. So $50 for a kid, $85 for an adult. That's because you get a seat. You get exactly the same snacks. It's all the same. Both categories of these dessert parties are exactly the same food. Okay? You're all eating at the same trough. So, the only difference is, for $85, you get a seat. A little off to the side, a better view, I think, than the Plaza Garden, where you have to stand. So that's the only difference of these. Guests who choose the less expensive Plaza Garden viewing option will see more of a dramatic price increase. What a surprise. With adult tickets now costing $69 up from $59. You got a $10 increase. That's pretty big. And kids going from $35 all the way up to $41. So, how does that taste? I don't know. That to me is an expensive cupcake. For $70, even to stand. Now you gotta stand, you still get the cupcakes that everybody else gets, and you gotta stand off to the side for $70 and $40. So for two people, you're looking $100 for two people, roughly about $50 a person. $50 a head as compared to $75 to $50 a head. It's so expensive. I mean, Disney is just throwing them out there. All right, moving on. We also have digital key is added to My Disney Experience in a few weeks. Disney's new digital key feature will be rolled out in the next few days as a feature within the existing My Disney Experience app. Guests with hotel reservations will be able to access their digital key from within the app on their check-in date and will be able to use their NFC compatible phone to quickly unlock their hotel room using their smartphone. I don't understand what's the point of this. In addition to being able to unlock the doors with this app feature, guests can also use their digital key inside My Disney Experience to unlock the hotel entrance gate and common area doors requiring a key, which may include pools, fitness centers, elevators, and club level lounges. Testing will begin in the next few weeks at Wilderness Lodge, where the feature will first debut before becoming available to other locations. Guests who want to use their digital key will need to opt in manually and activate the feature on their check-in day through a brief setup process in the app on their check-in date. Now, once the setup of the digital key is complete, guests can proceed directly to their room, open the My Disney Experience app, and then tap unlock door button. It's conveniently, what are the odds, located on the app's home screen while holding their phone against the door lock to gain entry. This, to me, this is exactly what your Magic Band. That was the point of the Magic Band. You know, so now you're taking the Magic Band, you're putting it in your phone. To me, putting your wrist up against the door or putting your phone up against the door, it's just something else for some, you know, something to fail. You're setting this up to fail. You're setting people up to, you know, now have more issues. You're going to have to deal with Wi-Fi issues. Then you're going to have to deal with, I'm getting locked out of my Disney Experience app. Or I forgot my password. Or my door won't open. Now what? You know, like, this is just, with technology comes more problems. We'll see how this one goes over at the Wilderness Lodge, because that's going to be out in a few weeks. This brings up that idea of the moneyless resort, where they tried to do a cashless resort where everything was on your wristband. Now they're probably trying to make that all onto your phone. They want you to use that My Disney Experience app for everything. And I guess eventually do away with Magic Bands, I guess. Because that's where it seems to be going. Now, also I wanted to mention, even though this one, I saw this story and it doesn't have anything to do with Disney. This is the other park, which is Universal Orlando. I thought this was a good idea to mention in this week's episode. With all the up hikes and the price increases that have been going on the past few weeks, ticket prices, the parkings, and all the upcharges now. A lot of people are in uproar about the amount of money that Disney is asking for. So what I noticed was that Universal confirmed last year that it would be opening not just one, but two new hotels on a 52-acre plot that was formerly occupied by the Wet n Wild Water Park. I remember they had plans to redo this, but nobody knew what they were going to do with it. So now they're making these the 7th and 8th on-site hotels at the resort. So you have eight hotels that you're able to stay at on property. Now these two new properties will add a combined total of 2,800 rooms to Universal, with the lion's share going to a huge 2,000 room resort on one side of Universal Boulevard and a 750-room resort across the street. Now this week, Universal confirms some new details about these new hotels, including the revelation that these two hotels will be part of a single complex known as Universal's Endless Summer Resort. which will feature two hotels, Surfside Inn Suites and Dockside Inn Suites. Both hotels will offer rates as low as $73 a night. Yes, $73 a night, which will introduce a new universal value hotel category. Now, they have the deluxe. They have like a moderate deluxe area of hotels out of those eight that they have. They have different kind of hotels over there. And now they're offering $73 a night hotel. Now, with Disney doing all these hotel upgrades and these things, the prices are going to go skyrocketing when they come out with all these new hotels over at Coronado. They're building the tower. Caribbean Beach, they're building a hotel over there. So with all these new things that they're adding, those prices are going to be high. Those are deluxe hotels. So you're talking $300, $400, $500, $600 a night. And Universal turns around and says, here, we have one for $73 a night. Universal, Disney needs to pay attention to Universal because they are knocking at the door. They're saying, hey, we know people are yelling and screaming about Disney spending so much money and wanting more money. They're paying attention. Universal is paying attention to what's going on, and they're offering you these options to stay there. So that's pretty enticing. When people are bitching about the fact that Disney is charging so much and Universal is now charging less, it just makes you think a little bit more about where you want to spend your money. And Disney needs to pay attention to that. I understand Star Wars Land is coming. I understand all these things are coming, Toy Story Land. But with that all coming and you're charging more and more prices, that's scary to some people. People back off when it comes to money. I would pay attention to what Universal's doing because they're listening to what Disney's doing. So it's just something to think about. That is it for the news this week. We will be back after this. Everybody, thank you for downloading. Thank you for listening to this week's show. A lot of stuff happening, a lot of news, a lot of info to have. I hope you can use some of this. The music, by the way, the music you heard on this week's episode was from a local band out of Providence called Cycle, P-S-Y-C-L-E. They're a local band. Check them out over at cyclemusic.com. Keep an eye on these guys. They are up and coming. If you like what you hear, they're on Amazon, they're on Twitter, they're on Facebook. Check them out over there, give them likes over there. Follow them if you could, because you definitely want to keep an eye on these guys. Other than that, that is it. If you have any questions, comments, suggestions, or anything, send them on over to goaskmickey.com. And till next time, Disney Nation, those are the words.
Head on over to GoAskMickey.com or check us out on Facebook or leave us a review on iTunes.